بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإنك لعلى خلق عظيم صدق الله مولانا العظيم وبلغنا رسوله الأمين الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. Today we shall be discussing about the importance of good character and good morals in the light of Quran and Hadith. It is really very important for us to know that how exactly are we supposed to be in our nature, in our characters, in terms of the Quranic and the prophetic teachings. That is really very important. But before coming to that, I would suffix here one more important thing, which is we as in human beings, right, not just as a Muslim, we as in human beings, when we are living in this world, the moment we are born, right, the moment we are born in this world, our parents, the mother or the father or the grandparents or whoever is related to you in that matter, we all dream that we should try to get the best possible things available to our children. Don't we do that? We perhaps, certainly we all do that. When you know, your wife is expected and she's about to give birth to a child, so you would think that it would be your dream. It would be your dream to take your wife to the best nursing home, to the best maternity hospital, to the best possible doctor you can actually afford. Right from the birth of your child, you would be planning, you would be dreaming that I should be working hard and hard and hard to get the best possible things in life for my children. Don't we all do that? Once the child starts up growing, so you'll be thinking to get him admitted into the best of the possible schools. So you'll be roaming around, you'll be doing the research work to find which of the school is the best for my child. So when slowly and steadily he starts growing up, he reaches the age of puberty, he or she, your children, then you want to get him admitted into the best of the colleges. Then you want to get him the best of the jobs. Once they are grown up and they are about to get married and they are ready to be married, when they are settled in life, you want to get him settled to the best possible manner. Thenceforth, you want your child to get married to the best possible spouse so that he could spend his life in the best possible manner. So thence on and on and on, this thing continues. And we always want the best possible thing for our children and for ourselves also, right? When we are into our childhood, when we are into our youth, when we are reaching the elderly, when we become old, we all plan our life in such a manner that we should all be getting the best possible things. So the best things comes into your mind that, you know, when somebody says this is the best, so you dream that and you wish that I should be getting that. So have you ever thought about which is best for you in the light of Quran and Hadith al-Mubarakah? Have you ever thought what exactly is this terminology all about? What makes us the best in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the sight of Allah's messenger, in the sight of the angels, and in the sight of the righteous people? So that is really, really very important. And we never pay attention to that part of our life. That is a very sad part of our reality. We should always be paying attention to that the most we can, because you should always try to be good in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because that is why you have been sent to this world. The reason behind our creation is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made us, has created us for his ibadah. Like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in Quran al-Majid that we have not created jinn and humans except for our worship. So you have been, I have been, and all have been created for the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So we should always strive harder and harder to become best. We should try to become best in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what is that which makes you best in the eyesight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Let's ask our beloved Prophet, what is that which actually makes us best in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? It is indeed, my dear friends. I have just recited an ayah, a verse from Surah Al-Qalam, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَإِنَّكَ لَأَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Let's come to the simple translation of this particular ayat al-mubarakah, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, O my beloved, and you surely possess the best of character. Subhanallah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about his beloved prophet, his morale, his character, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not just said that I have given you one of the good characters, I have given the character like Moses or Jesus or David or Jacob. No, my dear friends, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the best of the books, that is Quran al-Majid, that's also been referred as Kitab. The Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us to worship the best of the houses which we roam around and do tawaf when we go for the hajj. That is the best of the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the face of the earth. Likewise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has also given us the best of the prophets. No prophet could match the qualities, the attributes of our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallama, because he is simply the best, the most supreme among all of the Anbiya, approximately 124,000 messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were sent down to earth since from the birth of, since from the descending of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wa salam on this earth, on this world. So my dear friends, when we compare all these messengers with our beloved Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallama, no other prophet has been given this special maqam and this special station which our prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallama has enjoyed. His prophethood is not like any other prophet. No other prophet was given the prophethood, the level, the station, the magnificent station which our Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallama was blessed with. When we're talking about the mu'jizat al-Rasul which were given to our beloved sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, the muhaddiseen has quoted, the ashab has also quoted, the Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas has narrated that each of the prophet was given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to the maximum of 12, 13 miracles they could do. Not more than that they were allowed to perform when we're talking about the miracles of a particular prophet. But the Sahaba and Hazrat Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas has said, Allah's Messenger has said, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, I have been given all the miracles which were given individually to all of the prophets. Like the Nuh was given a mu'jiza or a miracle. Hazrat Sayyidina Isa alayhi salatu wa sallam, the Quran is shahid on this, that he was given a mu'jiza that he could bring back the dead to life. That was one of the mu'jiza Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam was given. But when we are talking about the mu'jizat of Rasul sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa alihi wa sallama, he was given all of the mu'jizat. And when we are talking about the moral character of our beloved sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Qalam, the pen, the Surah Al-Pen, which is also known as, in the verse number 4, has said, وَإِنَّكَ لَأَلَىٰ خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. O my beloved, and you surely possess the best of the character. That means that this kind of character which was imparted in our beloved sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, which was blessed with by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no other messenger has possessed these qualities. Alhamdulillah, we are so indeed very blessed to be his ummah. Alhamdulillah. Now when we are talking about the moral character, this is really very important for a Muslim to be of good character and good moral in his life, because moral character is one of the most important things in all of our life.